Hi, so here we have a motherboard from a Fujitsu Siemens laptop, V3505. Motherboard model number is Y41. So it doesn't work. In fact, it's not posting, so we don't have any image, USB activity, and so on. Since the laptop was repaired with another motherboard, I don't have the laptop anymore. I just have the board, but I thought that it would be a great experiment to see what's wrong with it. So what we have already done is try to flash the BIOS. Obviously we tried another CPU, other RAM sticks, but it doesn't make any difference. So for example, when we turn on the power, so here, shorting the power on pads, we can see that it's turning on. We have a green LED right here. I attach a post card there, so you can see that it's stopping on the 2C code with DRAM error. So since I wasn't able to figure out the problem originally, I thought that it was Northbridge related. They very rarely die, but you never know. So what I found interesting after attaching the postcard is that if I change the RAM slot, so here we have the other RAM slot, now let's turn it back on. You can see that now we are stopping on another code, which is F0. This is not supposed to happen because the RAM slots don't have any priority over each other. You can put the RAM stick in whatever slot you like. So basically that can confirm that our problem is RAM related. As I said, I already tried some other sticks, so it's not the RAM itself, so it must be from the motherboard. So what I tried, knowing that the Northbridge very, very failed on its own, was to see if there was more likely contact problem, for example if there is a ball causing an issue, a broken pad or something. I also have some hints from the machine, since it was in a very rough shape, probably dropped several times. So we are gonna put the RAM stick back in the other slot to see if it makes any difference. Remember, on this slot we had the C2 code. And now, what I'm gonna do is press somewhat hard on the Northbridge and turn on the board. And now we see that we are on code 38, which is obviously different. So if I turn back on without pressing on the Northbridge, we get code 2C. Let's try again by pressing on the Northbridge. 2C this time. Obviously, since it's making really bad contact, it's kinda hard to get it to make good contact. But here we go. This time we got 38 again. So another thing we can try is use our RAM tester, so since we are pretty sure there is an issue with the related to RAM slot contact or Northbridge contact. So if we insert our RAM tester, you can see that we have several LEDs that are not lighting up. And it's gonna be quite hard, but you can see that if I press on the last bridge, we have a flickering LED, and sometimes I can get even more to light up. See, here we have even more LED lighting up. So obviously, we really have a contact problem. If you check the other slot, same, we have some LEDs not lighting up. And if I press down on the last bridge, you can see that we get other LEDs to light up. So most likely the issue is contact under the nose bridge. Maybe, just maybe, we have bad contact with the RAM slots themselves, but as you could see, the LEDs that were not lighting up and were changing on the RAM slot tester were pretty much the same between the two RAM slots. So it will be really surprising if both RAM slots had the exact same problem, and with a closer inspection under the microscope, we cannot see any damage in the RAM slots themselves. So basically, the next step we are gonna take here is to rebuild the nose bridge. So in this case, I'm not gonna replace it at first because I don't think it's dead. But maybe we can solve the problem just by rebuilding the nose bridge. Hopefully we don't have any damaged pads under it. It's very common with this kind of problem that when you actually take out the nose bridge, you pull some pads on the corners, even though you were all balls were melted, you had the white profiles on the BGA workstation, because the pads were already damaged. So, just as a quick explanation on what I did with this postcard. So, this laptop cannot spit out postcodes on the mini PCIe slot. So, what we did here is hook up the postcard directly to the LPC bus. So LPC bus is a special bus that's generally used for the communication between the PCH and the embedded controller. And you can most of the times get the postcodes on this when it doesn't work, when you try to read them from the mini PCIe slot or other kind of methods. So this bus, so as you can see, I connected it right here. So this type of connector is found on some older Wistron board, which is this one here, and it's called the Golden Finger. So it's just a debug connector. I don't have the matching connector to put on them there, so I directly soldered my wires on it. So if we take a look at the schematics, you can see that this is the Golden Finger. Both sides of the board have the exact same pinout, and what we connected basically is a 3.3 volt power rail. We connected ground, we connected all the data lines, so LAD 0 to LAD 3, so 4 bits bus. We connected PCLK, which is the clock, connected L-frame, and we connected PCI reset, which is the reset signal. So basically with all that, connected, so if I show you closer, to our interface board, right here, just a record board to connect to the host card. So we have D0, D1, D2, D3, which are the LID signals. We have CLK, which was PCLK, reset, which was PCI reset, frame, which is L frame, and here ground and frequent reroute. So that way we could get the postcodes from the BIOS showing up on our debug card, like it's the case if we plug into the desktop board with the PCI slot. This method also works on some other laptop boards, Asus, Apple even. So as I said, the next step for this board is to take off the NOR switch. So it's kinda difficult to do it on camera, so it will be done off camera. Maybe we show the rebuilding process, and then we will see if that fixes the issue. Okay, so I took out the NOR switch, as I said earlier, and that's what we got under here. Unfortunately, as I feared, the pads under it were damaged. So, right here, this area you can see here matches with the bailout of the NOR switch, 945GM. So we are in this area, which contains a lot of RAM related signals. So SADQ, SBDQ are the first memory channel data lines and the second memory channel data lines. If we take a look at the schematics, you can see that we have DDR memory A with the SADQ signals here and DDR memory B with the SB signals here. So basically here there is nothing we can do to save this board because I'm not gonna run more than 1,000 jumpers for each of those signals. So yeah, it's not yet another donor board.